So we're going to go ahead and get started. One of the things I wanted to start off with is a reminder slash update slash just to go back over it again so everybody's on the same page about the blog post that we posted on April 7th about some changes that we are making to the marketplace store for how we sort items and how search works. So as an update, we are actively working on the best-selling sort that we mentioned at the end of the blog post. A lot of people have asked for some questions around that and kind of like where we're currently at for that project. So I am happy to say that we are actively working on it. It's not on our list of things to do. Someone is hammering away on that right now. But just as a reminder for what we're doing on the best-selling sort, we're currently changing to allow best-selling to now index each merchant store individually instead of the top 50,000 items that are listed site-wide. So if someone comes to your merchant store and they select the sort best-selling, it will now actively or accurately rank those items in that sort order by how well they're selling over a certain period of time. Prior to this, that was only really working correctly in two situations where if you did a product search, like not actually looking at someone's merchant store, if you hit best selling sort, it would sort those items in that product search by how well they're selling. And if you had an item in your store that happened to rank in the top 50,000, it would sort best selling when coming to someone's merchant store. Now we're expanding that across all items. So if you're a small seller or just if you want all of your items in your store being ranked according to how well they're selling, that will be coming very, very soon. We haven't landed on an exact date yet, but we'll be looking into that as well. When I say exact date, I mean to the question about what is the certain time period we'll look at. Something else I wanted to mention is for the best-selling sort, if anybody has any feedback on that, you can at any time reach out to me and DM me about that, and we're open to any suggestions. Okay, with that being said, I also wanted to give a reminder about a effort that we mentioned last time for cleaning up the marketplace. We have done this a few times in the past where if people who are inactive for certain long periods of time aren't able to do customer service or help with redeliveries anymore, if they are inactive and items aren't selling in their store, will be archiving their items and deactivating their store. So for exact specifics, I'm going to post the previous blog post.
Yep, I just dropped that in.
Oh, thank you, Alexa.
You bet.
But it's more or less the same rules. So the only thing that'll change, obviously, is that previous blog post was written for a certain date and time that's, you know, much earlier in the past. Now it is going to be within the last year. So if a merchant hasn't logged in 2 years and a specific product hasn't sold in 1 year, the product will be unlisted. If the merchant hasn't logged in 2 years and the store hasn't sold anything in 1 year, their store will be disabled. So, you know, that means if a product has sold within the past year, the product listing will remain available on the marketplace. If a store has products which have sold within the past year, it will remain enabled. And so when I say archiving, I really should say unlisting. Right, so you need to meet the criteria of not logging in within 2 years, and the store hasn't sold anything in 1 year.
Yeah, because there are people that don't log in a lot, but their products are still very active. They're working well. People love them. We don't want to take items like that down.
Yeah, so it when I said archiving, I meant it really the more accurate word should be delisting or unlisting. So if you were to log back in and reactivate, you could relist your products. One of the things I think you can do is in the merchant page where you can manage your listings, you check the box and make it active again.
Yeah, but if they're gems, that normally means they're selling. And this is really to help remove content that isn't selling where the user isn't around anymore. Because there's nothing worse than buying a product and something doesn't work and you try to contact the creator and they're nowhere to be seen. Yeah, that'll all be clearly termed out in the correct terms in the blog post. Correct.
Also, something to keep in mind, someone mentioned that there's some amazing products out there that are niche and not bought that often. If the merchant's active, right, you have to remember it's and. So if a merchant hasn't logged in 2 years and the product hasn't been selling. So if this merchant's active and they have an item that is no more niche and just doesn't sell it that often, that product will remain the same. It will not be unlisted. If you have specific examples of some of these, I'd love to see them just out of my own curiosity, too. When you say you'd like to be able to see if a merchant is active, you mean like if you went to their merchant store, there was some kind of badge by their name that shows how active they are? What is generally the reasons why you want to see that information? Seems like you're kind of interested in like preserving them for kind of like preserving the history of Second Life. Curious on the Zero Linden exception. Why specifically for Zero Lindens?
Not to totally derail this conversation, but another question we were talking about today was how many people use their shopping cart where they put stuff in the shopping cart and then they just leave it for some amount of time. And, I mean, me too, but why do y'all do it? The custom wish list names, more wish lists thing is something on the roadmap for someday. We've got a whole bunch of tickets about ways to improve wish listing.
I think I often do it because I want to be online when I finally get things delivered so I can unpack them and I don't forget I bought them. So I just kind of load my shopping cart as I find things I want. Does anybody else do that?
Speaking of wish lists, does anyone here ever look at a friend's wish list? So you may find something on the marketplace and then put it in your cart or your wish list as a to-do list to go then look for it in world. So one of the things I wanted to ask about is how often, if it was like weekly or monthly or daily, have you ever tried looking at the marketplace on a smartphone? When you say the SL browser, what do you mean? Okay, I see. So another question I had is, when you have a new product that you've created, how do you advertise that? If you're using something like Twitter or Discord, how do you just post a link to the product page? Like, how do you do that? When you're advertising a new product, I know somebody mentioned earlier about how Flickr can be difficult to deal with. Is there any major pain points that you have when trying to get the word out? So you would want to be able to follow stores so that way when they made an update that they've added something new, you could easily find it because it's kind of parses out all the spam. If you were to tweet out, a link to your store, a link to your product, would you tweet out the actual location in world or the marketplace product page? if you had to pick one channel that you were going to use, like let's say that you had to force rank them, like I know some people mentioned Discord, some people mentioned Twitter, some people mentioned in-group notifications. If you just had to pick one and you really wanted to get the word out about a new product you're adding to your store, which one would you pick? I'm curious about the comment where it says that you liked an activity pub plugin for Marketplace. Could you add some more details about that?
Oh, yeah, it's really useful. You just go through, favorite all your stores, and then you go into your name and go to favorites and stores. And I have it sorted by, I just put this together, sort it by age, and you can see the latest products from all of the stores. That way you don't miss anything.
It's a great question. How would you like to be notified if you were to choose? Let's say we did give you a personal homepage with feeds on it. What would you like to see in them? I know people have mentioned favorite stores and then updates of those favorite stores. Is there anything else you'd be interested in seeing? Updates to products you own is definitely an interesting one. let's say we did give you dates on the listings. Which date would you be most interested in? Where there's created date, listing date, last modified. What was the additional information that you try to include? Like version and release date? Materials it uses, okay. If we were to do something where we have some kind of design for SL quality mark, what does that mean to you? Like it has a certain land impact or what? I think a good question would be, what do we think makes someone verified? So is it that they have a certain level of quality to products that we all find acceptable? Is there like a threshold we would set for that? What are like 2 to 3 things that you really look for in someone that makes them like you would say, oh, this person really deserves like a quality badge? Oh, interesting. So someone else is kind of doing like a review of the product in a blog, or they're just blogging about it, talking about how much they like it, or it's featured in the blog. What are some of like the common barriers to entry that you've experienced for a new designer? I'm a little confused by your question. I don't remember saying anything about auto-changing marketplace listings maturity rating.
This is, I'm from Yuzuru, from Lucy. I'm guessing that it's along the lines of when something gets flagged for being in the wrong maturity, that support usually delists. And Lucy thinks that it's automatically changing keywords instead of delisting, but we haven't changed that process as far as I know.
The Turbo Squid example is a great example. I'll definitely take a look at that. Just out of curiosity, what do you use Turbo Squid for in your kind of like day-to-day work? Oh, interesting. Okay.
Darkover, how would checking out a gift without having to put it in the cart work?
Also, why do you want to not have it go in the cart? Just simple, quick, easy use, or
Oh, okay. Like a buy now as a gift button, like Lexo or AXO? Can't tell. Thanks, Yuzuru.
I
Okay.
see. Okay.
A buy now, send as gift button without having to do it through the shopping cart. Got it.
That is a great suggestion. Thank you for bringing that up.
I thought we were talking about a way to preview items for a sec, and that's also interesting but harder.
Definitely take a look into that. Thank you for bringing it up. So we're at time. Thank you so much for coming today. If you have any other questions, you can always feel free to reach out to me in World. I'll be happy to answer them. Everybody who came up with new and unique ideas for us to take a look at and have feedback, we always really appreciate it. Looking forward to seeing you all again next month.